Hey folks, Matt from ArtOfTheImage.com. Just fooling around with the beautiful little X-T20. For those of you that are regular viewers, you will know that the X-T20 is one of my, probably one of my all-time favorite cameras. It's a beautiful little offering from Fuji. Gives you 90-something percent of the goodness of the Fuji X-T2 in a smaller, lighter, less expensive body. I love it. As seen here, we've got the Fuji 50 F2 on it. Beautiful little lens, great prime. One of my favorite kit lenses of all time is the 18-55 f/2.8-4. You've probably heard me talk about this again. Probably the nicest kit lens ever made. If it's not the nicest, it's in the top three easily. I think it's probably the nicest one I can ever recall to date. Fit and finish, build quality, optics, everything, just stellar. Why am I talking about thinking about playing with the X-T20? Well, maybe you know, maybe you don't, but the X-T100 has been announced from Fuji. I was just going over the press release here, and the lead paragraph says, Fujifilm North America today announced the debut of its new Fujifilm X-T100, compact interchangeable lens camera with a sleek design, available in black, dark silver, and champagne gold. The new X-T100 offers a host of features, including a high magnification EVF, horizontal tilting rear LCD screen, built-in Bluetooth, and extended battery life, allowing up to 430 frames per charge. In addition, the X-T100 weighs just 448 grams with anodized coating on the top aluminum top cover, delivering a simultaneously retro and luxurious feel. It's got me excited because the price point on this, let me double check, make sure I have that right for you. The price point is going to be $599 US or $699 with the brand new 15-45. It's a new Fujinon XC 15-45 3.5-5.6 variable aperture lens. So very exciting. And that lens actually may be the best option for people just getting into a Fuji system, getting in at this lower end, good value camera. Instead of going, this would cost you a fair bit more to get into that kit or to add that lens. So for the price, I think most people, plus you get 15 mils on the wide end, 15-45, I think it's a great deal. The new X-T100 is going to have a full variangle LCD, flips out, so it gives you the ability to do like selfies, to do video, monitor yourself, like I'm shooting with the G85 right now and the screen's out and you can see what's going on. I think every camera should have that, and luckily, or thankfully, the new X-T100 does. Now, to review what else we have in here, we have a 24 megapixel APS-C CMOS. Now I should note here that this is not an X-Trans sensor. In other words, the X-T20 is still a fairly significant upgrade to the X-T100 in the sense that you'll get that really nice X-Trans sensor, and it's so you're in that level. The X-T20 has it, and on up into the X-T2, the X-Pro 2, and the other cameras. The X-T100 does not. So it's still decent 24 megapixel APS-C sensors, just not the X-Trans. We've got a 3-inch 1040K dot high resolution touchscreen. Again, it's variangle tilt. Standard output for sensitivity for ISO, 200 to 12,800 with a bump to 100 to 51,200 on the extended settings. So this is all fairly standard, fairly competitive to the X-T20. 4K video, we can go now up to approximately 30 minutes on the new X-T100. But the caveat again here is that it only does 15 frames per second. And I'll talk about that more later because that's a pretty significant spec right there you want to be aware of. We got Bluetooth, we got Wi-Fi, we got an improved battery life, 430 frames. Startup time is 0.4 seconds. It looks like a fantastic offering. I'm actually really excited about it because I love the X-T20, but I think this is smart of Fuji because the X-T100 at this price point, $599 or $699 with a body, or with a lens with the body, $599 just for the body, puts it at a very very value-priced price point, allows people to get into the Fuji system. And perhaps most significantly for me, I'm very excited because they've gone to the full vari-angle LCD. The X-T20 has a flip-up. You can't flip it out and look at it from this direction, but you'll be able to with the X-T100. So in that sense, the X-T100 has one of the most advanced LCDs, the best LCD of any of the Fuji lineup at the moment. That's going to make it a very attractive camera for a lot of people. So I'm pretty excited about it. I think this could be a very good seller for Fuji. I think it's a good move. It's a smart move. But there are the two points that we're going to discuss in another video that I want to go over with you. Caveats, reasons you may not wish to buy, reasons possibly to upgrade to the X-T20 that we'll discuss. But mostly, I'm pretty excited about this camera. So I'm going to throw it back to you guys. What do you think? Were you expecting this announcement? Does the X-T100 excite you? Could it be your first Fuji? Are you thinking about adding it to your bag because you own a X-Pro2 or an X-T2 and you think the X-T100 would be a nice small addition as a second body? Let me know in the comments below what your thoughts and feelings are on the announcement of the X-T100. Curious to see what you guys have to say. Let's discuss it in the comments below. Thanks for tuning in, folks. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.